Greetings, my brothers and my sisters, the Reverend Dr. Sonny Bridges, pastor of the Bethlehem Number One Missionary Baptist Church in Conway, South Carolina. Certainly, we are grateful tonight, another day that the Lord has brought us, another day that the Lord has been good to all of us, and we just thank God, especially to you, social media. We want to keep on praying, keep lifting the name of the Lord up, because he said, if he be lifted up, you'll draw all men unto him. Another exciting study tonight, Soul School on Wednesday. I'm excited tonight to be coming again with my beautiful wife, Evangelist Bridges. Thank God, amen, for her, amen. We bless the Lord and thank God. And we're not going to tarry. We're going to get into this word tonight and see what the Lord want to teach us tonight. I'm going to ask Sister Bridges to come up with a word of prayer, and then we'll get started.
Let us pray. Amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord,
yes,
thank
Lord.
You once again
for thank you, Lord.
Being here, Lord God, and
thank
being
you.
Able, Lord God, to disciple your word.
All right.
Being able to teach your word, Lord God, that it fall on good ground, Lord God. All of us, Lord God, we can do your will. Lord God, we ask you to bless everyone that's listening on the sound of our
voice,
Lord God, that will
yes.
fall on good ground, and they will go out telling other men, women, boys, and girls that the
thank
way we sin
Lord.
Is death and the gift of God's eternal life.
Thank you, Lord.
Just have your way in our lives tonight. Help us to be bold soldiers and good disciples.
Thank you,
in
Lord.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Jesus'
amen.
Name. Amen and amen. As always said, prayer still works and prayer still changes things. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight, our lesson tonight, we are in the we have about three scriptures we're going to look at tonight as our text scripture. And our subject tonight in this lesson is Mary Magdalene, a faithful disciple. Mary Magdalene, a faithful disciple. For those who may not have a book, we use our Sunday school book as we teach from. Some of you may not have this book or this lesson, but it's Mary Magdalene, a faithful disciple. Our lesson tonight is coming from Luke. Chapter 8, verses 1 through 3. Luke chapter 8, verses 1 through 3. Then Mark chapter 15, verse 40. And then we go to John. That's the Gospel of John, chapter 20, excuse me, verses 10 through 18. And we've been dealing with this lesson for a while, the calling. We're seeing how the Lord called him, how he called evangelize, called to evangelize, called to proclaim. Tonight, he's just dealing with the ladies tonight, the women. He's been dealing with for the last couple weeks, teaching us the importance of women in the ministry. Amen. I think that's important that we understand that tonight. But again, our lesson is outlined. We follow the format from our lesson. Aim for Change teaches us, conveys to us what we're going to learn from the lesson. Then give us in focus, give us a story that kind of relates to the lesson. Then we go into the keep in mind is the verse. Within the lesson itself. And so we're going to ask Sister Bridget Wood to read our Aim for Change and Focus and our Keep in Mind verse.
Right.
Thank you.
Mary Magdalene, a faithful disciple.
Amen.
Aim for Change.
Mm-hmm.
By the end of this lesson, we will discern Mary Magdalene's motivation for committing her life to Jesus.
Amen.
Appreciate the sacrifices Mary Magdalene made in order to follow Jesus
and
embrace a lifestyle of wholehearted discipleship.
Just keep that in mind about Mary Magdalene, and we're going to learn some lessons from Mary Magdalene, because we're going to discover tonight all of us at one time have been like Mary Magdalene. Amen. In focus, though.
And folks, it was a wearing plane ride from San Diego to the military hospital overseas. But Jackie got no rest. She was too anxious. This was not the reunion she wanted for her and her husband, Bruce, a lifelong Army officer whose career had taken him to deployment across the United States and around the world.
Mm.
Every time Bruce was reassigned, they dutifully made the move, understanding that they were together in marriage no matter where it took them.
Amen.
They packed everything they had, and she took on the challenge of settling into new housing, making new friends and supporting him, even as their family grew from 2, 3, then 4. But the family wasn't allowed to follow when Bruce was stationed at Camp Afrika in Kuwait, which meant Jackie leaned harder on her faith that her husband would be safe. Before Bruce left, he gave her a bracelet engraved with the mitzvah: "The Lord watch between me and thee when we are absent from one another."
Mm-hmm.
4 months that carried her through. Then came word that Bruce was injured in a vehicle crash. Now Jackie stood in a hospital corridor being told Bruce had been moved just before her arrival, but it wasn't clear where. As an army chaplain and administrator tried to sort out the confusion, a kind, charged nurse saw Jagger's distress. Mm. "Don't let worry overtake you now," she said with a smile. Mm. "Believe me, with a loving partner like you in his corner, he'll be fine." Mm. "Can we trust God to take care for those we love wherever they are?"
Oh my God, isn't that awesome there, Jackie? And I know my wife is Janice, and she can witness with mm-hmm. Jackie as being a military wife. Amen. Mm-hmm. And times that I had to deploy and go to other places in the United States and could not carry my family. But I'm grateful tonight as we look at this story, God always have someone. Mm-hmm. He always sends someone your way to encourage you. Mm-hmm. Amen. And matter of fact, my brothers and sisters, I told you sometimes you got to learn to encourage yourself, because that's what Jack was doing when he left that bracelet with her. Uh-huh. But then when she discovered he got hurt, then it went through another whole different direction. But that's the time when you really got to learn to lean and what? Trust in God.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Mm-hmm. And that is a true statement that we can trust God.
Yes.
And
yes.
The reason that we can trust him, because 1 Peter 5:7 says that we got to cast all our cares.
Amen.
Upon him, because what he cares for us.
Amen.
Prayer is the key. And that's always said it every Sunday, because God is no limit. There's no limit on what he can do.
What he can do.
His arms are just as long and wide as
Amen.
He can cover us all.
Thank
so
you.
So he'll take care of us.
Hallelujah.
Even though you got all, when we can't trace him.
Hey, you can trust him when you can't trace.
You can't trace.
And that's what this is awesome tonight. Thank you, Sister Bridget, because in that last paragraph, when the chaplain met up with Jackie, and then there was a nurse who also approached her, could see the distress on her face. But I like what that nurse said, Sister Bridget. She said, "Don't let worry overtake you now." Amen. That's what Sister Bridget said. 1 Peter 5:7, cast all your cares on him.
That's right.
And I said that on Sunday in our sermon. Don't worry.
Don't worry.
Amen. Throw it up to the Lord. Uh-huh. Amen. Praise his holy name.
Hallelujah.
We're going to see Mary Magdalene was in a whole different ball game all by herself as she followed the one whom our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. So we need to keep in mind, please.
To keep in mind is the 12 were with him, and certain women which had been healed of evil spirits and infirmities, Mary called Magdalene, out of whom went seven devils.
Seven devils.
Luke 8:1-2.
Luke 8:1-2. And this is from the New Living Translation. New Living Translation said, he took his 12 disciples with him, along with some women, and had been cured of evil spirit and disease. Among them was Mary Magdalene, from whom he had cast out seven demons. And my brothers and sisters, I want you to understand, getting into the lesson tonight, keep that mind, keep that name in mind of Mary Magdalene, because that name seems to stick out in this lesson. Amen. Tonight, even though the subject of Mary Magdalene, a faithful disciple. What we've been doing lately here in our lesson, we've been going to our background and also people, places, and things. And then we come back and read the lesson. And reading the lesson, we read the New Living Translation. What's a little better understanding of the scriptures tonight. But Mary Magdalene, a faithful what? Disciple. Then let me say this before we get into people, place, and time. Amen. That a disciple, and we need to understand what a disciple is. The term means one who is engaged in learning through instruction from another pupil or apprentice in religious concepts such as the Bible. That's what a disciple. One writer said, disciple is one who is ever what? Learning. We always learning. Amen. And I'm glad Jesus said, go ye to the world. And he said, what? Make what?
Disciple.
Make disciples. He didn't say make members. Amen. Because when you make a member will leave you in time. But if you make a disciple is one who is a follower of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen. And so when we look at this lesson tonight, people, places, and time. It talks about demonic possession, demons, evil spirit beings. So for those who don't have a book, evil spirit, you can write it down, Matthew chapter 8, verse 16, also Matthew chapter 12, verse 43 and 45. You might want to write these scriptures down. Who are enemies of God, who have certain power over people. Let me talk about demons. Amen. Remember I said, what have certain power over people? Amen. Amen. That's why Paul said in Ephesians chapter, 6, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, all right, but against, principalities and high places, all right? So there's a one. James 2:19, write it down. They belong to the number of fallen angels. They left their first estate, that's Jude 6, talking about demonic now, demonic possession, mentioned quite often in the New Testament, all right? Also in Mark 9:17, talks about the muteness of a person, all right? Then the gospel clearly that Christ is distinguished between ordinary sickness and demon possession. You might write that down. Christ distinguished between ordinary sickness and demon possession. Mm-hmm. Jesus generally healed sick people by laying his hand on them, mm-hmm. all right? But when it came to a demon, he cast them out. Mm-hmm. Amen. Mm-hmm. Remember that. He healed the sick by laying his hand on them. But when he got to a demon, he cast them out. Amen. Amen. All right. And then we look at the background, Mary Magdalene. Now, this is something because no one really knows, First Lady and social media, what type of demon Mary Magdalene was dealing with. Mm-hmm. Amen. Some talk about the prostitute. She being in Simon's house. Some scholars assume Mary Magdalene is the first name in Luke 8:2. That's a simple woman who anointed Jesus in Simon's house. What we really learned about Mary Magdalene, that she was a woman from whom seven demons had gone out. And she was close follower of the friend of Jesus. And also, we're going to write down Mark 15:40, which is part of our lesson on tonight as well. But we also know about Mary Magdalene. We're going to get into the lesson in a moment. She was one that went to the tomb, went where Jesus was buried. And I'm telling you, my brothers and sisters, in order for that woman to want to go where Jesus was buried, that means she must have been in touch with the Lord. Amen. Anytime you meet the Lord, you want to follow him.
That's right.
If you really meet him.
That's right.
If you really meet him, you want to follow him. Amen. Amen. And so our lesson tonight, there's three outlines in our lesson. Number one, the 12 and some women. The 12 and some women, that's Luke 8:1-3. The 12 and some women. Then number two, refusing to leave the scene. That's Mark 15:40, refusing to leave the scene. And number three, looking for signs of resurrection. Mm. That's John chapter 20, verses 10 through 18. Mm. Amen. So my brother and sister, if we look at this first outline, the 12 and some women. You would, Sister Bridget, read that from the New Living Translation. Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
And it says, soon afterwards, Jesus began a tour of the nearby towns and villages.
All right.
Preaching and announcing the good news about the kingdom of God. He took his 12 disciples with him.
All right.
Along with some women.
All right.
Who had been cured of evil spirits and diseases.
Yes, sir.
Among them were Mary Magdalene, from whom he had cast out seven demons.
All right.
And Joanna, the wife of Cusa, Herod's business manager.
Yes.
Suzanne, and many others who were contributing from their own resources to support Jesus and his disciples.
All right. Now, brothers and sisters, if you look at that first outline, the 12 and some women, and that's Luke 8:1-3, Sister Bridget just read that, talks about Jesus' earthly ministry. And Jesus, now, brothers, don't get upset. And I know sometimes it seems like you overlook the brother, but I want y'all to know it's not about the brothers tonight. It's about the women. Amen. Amen. It's about the women. And I said this on one previous study. Listen, one preacher said, if all the women leave the church, he gonna catch the last dress tail. That means he leaving too. Amen. Amen. Because we realize that women are important in ministry.
Amen.
Amen. And the Lord is demonstrating this to us tonight in this lesson. Jesus' ministry, it takes him all over Galilee. He traveled with 12 disciples. But what most important, a group of women accompanied him. They traveled with Jesus. And there was one in particular, Mary Magdalene, who had been cured of what? Evil spirit. Amen. Because from the town, she got a name from the town of what? Magdala. Amen. Mm-hmm. And also there was another one that traveled with him, what? Joanna. Now I thought this was interesting, Bridget, that we studied it. Amen. Now Joanna, you have to understand, who traveled with them, she was the wife of Herod and Stewart. Herod, right, is Stewart. Mm-hmm. So that means that her husband worked for Herod.
That's right.
Now, could you imagine And that could have been some trouble there. Amen. But even in the midst of that, what? That was Joanna, also her faithfulness. Mm-hmm. Amen. You see, and then Joanna, who being one of the women, along with Mary Magdalene, isn't that something, brothers and sisters? Who were first discovered with Jesus. Now this is right. Who were first discovered with Jesus at the tomb. And that's Luke 24 and 10. But there was another name, what? Susanna. Uh-huh. And she traveled with them as well. Now, the women who traveled with Jesus and decided they provided, they was not just with Jesus, but they provided resources.
That's right.
Amen. And food. Amen. They were there to what? Provide. They supported Jesus.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Mm-hmm. And another thing is, while Jesus was out preaching and teaching in the ministry,
right?
You know, his preaching and teaching could have been hindered.
All right, all right.
Yeah. Greatly hindered.
Greatly
if
hindered.
If it had not been for the women.
All right, all right.
That were providing the daily needs for him and these apostles
that
were there.
Yes.
And we see that, you know, Jesus and these 12 were able to devote themselves fully to the ministry.
To the ministry.
Because of these women
that
were there.
Amen, amen. And that's almost like Acts chapter 6. Because when you read that, and I want to use that as a contrast, Sister Bridget, because when they said, look out among you and mm-hmm. get some men that full of good reputation, filled with the Holy Ghost, uh-huh. amen. And then the Bible said that we may appoint them over this business. And then they said that we'll have more time with the word.
Right.
So when you got people support you, this is what's going on here now. Uh-huh. Jesus was preaching the word.
That's right.
The word of God. Amen. And we see Jesus as he began to teach. Amen. Look at the support that Jesus had. And we see the what? Now, in Luke 8, we see them what? They are following Jesus. Mm-hmm. Keep that in mind. They are following Jesus. Mm-hmm. Remember, I told you the disciples, one who what? Want to follow Christ.
Right.
Follow Christ, not only follow Jesus, but you want to follow his teaching. Mm-hmm. And it seemed though, the gospel seemed to, to kind of exercise the men, mm-hmm. all right? But women were important. Because now during the first century, the women, it was kind of hard on the women. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Because Israel was a different time during that time, mm-hmm. especially the first century dealing with the women.
Mm-hmm.
But when we look at this 21st century, we know that look, Jesus broke the tradition, huh?
Mm-hmm.
In regard to the women,
that's right.
Jesus broke that tradition. That's Amen. Right. Jesus demonstrated compassion and respect. Then, but not on that, but Jesus ministered to the women mm-hmm. by offering forgiveness, deliverance, and healing.
Mm-hmm.
What happened to Mary Magdalene mm-hmm. when she met Jesus. Right. Amen. That was a transformation going on.
That's right.
In her life.
That's right. That's right. These women have been transformed by Jesus.
Amen.
And like Pastor said earlier, if you've been touched by Jesus, there's something going on there. If you're going to follow him.
If you're going to follow him.
That's right. And they served him in these many practical ways.
Yes, yes.
And mostly about going out and serving him and giving up their private means.
My Lord.
Of whatever they had.
Yes,
and,
yes.
You know, we have sometimes, you know, it's hard for us to give out our beans.
My Lord.
You know.
My Lord.
We don't realize that that's ministry too.
That's ministry too.
You know. And this here just affirms that. The importance of these women in the word, in the gospel is important.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
These women who followed Jesus on his missionary journey, they continued to follow him. They didn't stop.
Oh, thank you. Mm-hmm. So you had a good point right there. She mm-hmm. said they continued to follow him. They didn't stop.
Right.
Because when we pick it up in this next part here, and let me just say this before we move on, because like I said, Jesus healed them. Jesus taught them alongside of the men.
Mm-hmm.
Women were first to see the risen Christ. So mm-hmm. they didn't stop, but they followed him. Mm-hmm. Just keep that in mind. Women was equal recipients of the Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 2, mm-hmm. verse 17 and 18. All right? And we see that what? Mary is included in the life of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
And since we just said it, they took what? They took a part in providing for Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
It was unusual for women to travel with the rabbi.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
But Jesus set a new standard by creating a place for women in his ministry.
Right.
Oh, I don't know who I'm teaching tonight, but I pray to God that you grab a hold of this. Women, oh Lord have mercy.
Mm-hmm.
Women are important in the ministry of Jesus. They are important. They are important.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let nobody fool you. But there was something about Mary, that transformation, Sister Bridget,
mm-hmm.
it was awesome. Because Jesus, what? He healed her from what? Demon possession.
That's right.
Seven demons, they said. And we don't know what they were. And I wonder tonight, What kind of demons you dealing with? Lust. Come on, somebody. What kind of demons you dealing with?
Right.
Backbiting. Lying. Amen.
That's right.
So these women. Amen.
Now these women that, like you said, had all been healed of something miraculous about Jesus.
Oh, my Lord.
And all these women were different in part.
Yes, yes.
But all of them had something in common.
Great God Almighty.
Amen.
Ooh.
Jesus had healed them of a condition.
Yes. Yeah,
in which there was no human solution. And they were up beyond human help.
Look at that.
So nobody can do this for them but Jesus.
But Jesus.
And just like that, nobody can do to us the way we should be done but Jesus.
What a transformation. Now, that was a transformation. Therefore, 2 Corinthians 5:17. Mm-hmm. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things are passed away.
New.
Behold, he become what?
New.
And this, I got to just share my note with you because that transformation was awesome. But she began, watch this here. This is a note for somebody. She began as a prisoner of demons.
Mm.
Now she's a bearer of his word to the disciple. She went from what? Carrying demons to carrying the word.
That's
enough to make you shout right there.
That's right.
She went from carrying demons to carrying
the
word of God. Woo! I got to give myself a hand. Hallelujah. I got to praise him.
But you know, don't you know that Jesus could have provided everything he needed?
Absolutely.
He didn't need us
Amen.
To do it. He didn't need anybody to do anything for him. But God, it was because of the love that he had for us.
This is awesome. This is awesome. This is awesome.
And he uses us as vessels.
As vessels.
To show people the love that we should have for one another.
Amen. Amen.
You know, supporting each other.
Supporting each other. There's no reason we are not to support it. If you're a child of God, I'm not supporting for people doing wrong. But if you're a child of God, we ought to be able to support one another.
Especially in the gospel.
In the gospel of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. Amen. And so this lesson really, I'm telling you, it's an awesome lesson. And I love it because now we see what she began to do. She began to evangelize.
Mm-hmm.
That's what she did.
That's right.
I need to drop in on someone the word evangelize. All right? And you ever looked at that word evangelize? Because we're going to find out something later on that was some angels that they ran into. We're going to get into that in a moment. Let me come back to the evangelize.
Mm-hmm.
Because we know God used angels as messengers.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. All right? So we see here the 12 and some women, right?
Mm-hmm.
But look, go to 15 and 40. Now remember, these women were following Jesus. Look at that 40. Uh-huh.
15:4 says, some women were there watching from a distance, including Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, the younger and of Joseph, and Shalom.
All right. Now we see they refused to lead the scene.
Mm-hmm.
What scene, brothers and sisters? Mm-hmm. Social media? The resurrection, the crucifixion.
Mm-hmm.
The crucifixion.
Mm-hmm.
They refused to lead the scene.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying our Lord is saying to crucify. And so what? If they travel with Jesus, they support him in life and in death.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them say, I'll be with you, but when it get tough,
that's right.
You can't find
him.
But Mark here, they was witnesses of Jesus' crucifixion and his resurrection.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you, brothers and sisters, Mark did not indicate that the disciples remained at the foot of Jesus' cross. But he does know there were women who looked on from a distance. They said nothing about the brother.
That's
nobody
right.
said nothing about the brother. Go ahead, Bridget.
But you know, they were looking for them distant.
Yeah.
But the thing about it was they was in the very presence of enemies.
Amen.
You know, you're like the disciples wanted to run away.
All right, all right.
But these women stood.
Amen.
Before these here people that was crucifying Jesus.
Lord have mercy.
They weren't afraid.
They weren't afraid.
They were gonna stay there to the end.
To the end.
That's right.
And said the disciples, them boys ran away.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Peter and John ran there twice. They ran there one time and ran back. Amen. And the second time they ran all the way in the tomb.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
They wanted to see what had happened. But these women, Mary Magdalene, there at the crucifixion, meant to be what? That was a shameful execution.
Mm-hmm.
People would not normally associate themselves with such a person. If you were being crucified according to the Roman law, you don't want to be around that person.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
That's right.
Crucifixion demonstrates the total power of the Roman Empire. People who were crucified served as an example, Lord have mercy, to Roman citizens what happened when one crosses the Rome.
Mm-hmm.
These women, I love this, associated themselves with someone who was a threat to the empire, who was Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that something?
Mm-hmm.
And somebody said they didn't run, they stayed what? right there. That's in other words, they didn't desert Jesus.
That's right. They stayed far enough so they can hear their Savior.
Lord Jesus.
They wanted to see what he's saying. Lord Jesus. If he was saying anything, Lord, they wanted to be at his beck and call.
They was there. It's not only them, but it's amazing that they were there for his death, but they were coming to, they was planning to anoint his body on the morning of his resurrection. I'm talking about the women. When was the last time you supported someone or something until the end, even knowing that you would not receive the result from which you hoped and prayed for? Now that's tough there.
That's right.
Hanging on in there.
That's right.
When you don't know what the end gonna be.
Even through pain and suffering.
Oh my God, isn't that awesome, man? But look here, but they was eyewitnesses. Yeah. Isn't that something?
Right.
They was eyewitnesses of the crucifixion of Jesus, Mary, the mother of James, Salome, the mother of James and John. Mm-hmm. Now, isn't that something? Women witnessed. Now, this is awesome. The women witnessed the bearer of Jesus. And their devotion, Lord, exceeded the men. Since we just said, they run. Mm-hmm. Which they deserted Jesus. Now, watch this here. They claim now. Look at them. They claim they were what? They will remain with Jesus until he died.
That's right.
But women what? Remain. And that's what I love. The women what? They stayed right there.
Mm-hmm.
And when you see in this lesson here, though it was right, look what the women were there where? Until the death of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And this is awesome, brothers and sisters. They stayed there. They remained there. And that's why it's important if you're in Christ. I said, if you're in Christ, you'll stay in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. That thing about once saved, always saved. I know it's been a debate on all this here, but I'm going to share this with you tonight. You either saved or you're not
That's
saved.
Right.
So there won't be no problem.
Because
you don't even have to debate that once saved, once always saved.
That's right.
Because if you're saved, you're saved.
That's right. No debate.
No debate. Amen. And that's the way I look at it. There's no debate on this thing. All this lesson is good tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Learning about Mary Magdalene. So the first part we see how the women, they followed Jesus. And then the second part, they refused to leave the scene. They was witnesses of his bearer and resurrection. They was witnesses.
Yeah.
They stayed right there. And I think this is awesome for us to see tonight. But look at this, the third outline. We get in good time. The third outline.
Third line, John 20.
Uh-huh. John 20, 10 through 18.
Okay.
And that's looking for the signs of resurrection. Now look at this. It's going to get good here.
Then they went home.
Mm-hmm.
Mary was standing outside the tomb crying.
My Lord.
And as she wept, she stooped and looked in.
Listen here. Listen.
She saw two white-robed angels, one sitting at the head and the other at the foot of the place where the body of Jesus had been lying.
My God.
Dear women, why are you crying?
Yeah.
The angel asked her. Because they had taken away my Lord, she replied.
Yeah.
And I don't know where they have put him.
Mm.
She turned to leave and saw someone standing there.
Yeah.
It was Jesus, but she didn't recognize him.
All right.
Dear woman, why are you crying?
Yeah.
Jesus asked her,
uh-huh.
Who are you looking for?
All right.
She thought he was the gardener.
Yeah.
Sir, she said, if you had taken him away, tell me where you have put him.
Listen.
And I will go and get him.
Mm.
Mary, Jesus said, she turned to him and cried out, Rabboni, which is Hebrew for teacher.
Right.
Don't cling to me, Jesus said.
Listen.
For I haven't yet ascended to the Father.
Uh-huh.
But go find my brothers and tell them, I'm ascending to my Father and your Father.
Lord.
To my God and your God.
Lord Jesus.
Mary Magdalene found the disciples and told them, I have seen the Lord.
Listen.
Then she gave them his message.
Gave them his message. Don't forget this, brothers and sisters. She gave him, what?
His
message. And we see this here. They're looking for signs of the resurrection.
Mm-hmm.
Mary is the first, what, at the empty tomb. And you can find that in John 20. Verses 1 through 2, if you look at the context of this lesson. Amen. Then all that. But then Peter and John went. And then when they got there, they went to an empty tomb. They thought someone had what? Taken Jesus' body.
Mm-hmm.
Then they returned back home.
Mm-hmm.
Now look at this here now. Peter and John and Mary feared that someone had taken Jesus' body. But look, but Mary, she was unwillingly. Now look, Peter and John left.
Mm-hmm.
But Mary was unwilling.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that something? To leave the tomb without trying to determine who had took Jesus' body.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that awesome?
Mm-hmm.
Mary remained at the tomb. I thought this was a good note because of her devotion to Jesus.
Right.
Mary, what? Her grief prevented her from me to recognizing Jesus. Because there in the tomb, Mary left. Not only was she outside the tomb, but she went inside. Mm-hmm. Ain't that something? And going inside there, she began to talk to some people there. Mm-hmm. When I said some people, it was some angels.
Yeah.
And that led me to this note that the angels was there. And this is important. There's a note, I made a note about those angels on my lesson. It talks about them in the book of Exodus, like at the mercy seat, in the place of the holiness of holiness. Mm-hmm. And I think I wrote it down somewhere to make sure I didn't get it, but if not, I'll bring it back to you later. It was in the book of Exodus. Exodus, write it down, Exodus 25, verses 17 through 19. That's Exodus 25, verses 17 through 19. Look at it. Let's say, Rich, go ahead. And let's read that. Amen. Because now we find Mary up there looking for the signs of the resurrection. Amen. And she's there. And my brother says, I love the way this story unfolds to us tonight.
How, Exodus 25.
Yeah, Exodus 25, verses 17 through 19. That's Exodus 25, because that said it was two angels there. Mm-hmm. And this is almost like a contrast to the tabernacle, to the place of the holiness of holiness. In Exodus 25, dealing with that mercy seat. 25, verse 17 through 19.
Okay, and it reads, and thou shalt make a mercy seat of pure gold.
All right.
2 cubits and a half shall be the length thereof.
Uh-huh.
And a cubic and a half the breadth thereof. And thou shalt make 2 cherubims of gold.
Right, right.
Of beaten work shall thou make them. In the 2 ends of the mercy seat.
Listen, that's at the mercy seat. Go ahead.
And make 1 cherub on the one end and the other cherub on the other end.
Uh-huh.
Even of the mercy seat shall you make the cherubims on the 2 ends thereof.
Right.
And the cherubims shall stretch forth their wings on high.
Listen.
Covering the mercy seat with their wings, and their faces shall look one to another.
Lord have mercy.
Towards the mercy seat shall the face of the cherubims be.
Oh.
And thou, right,
what verse?
19. It's 19. Thereof.
All right, thereof. And that's it. So I just want to give that scripture to y'all tonight. Y'all can see the contrast of where the angels were at. All right, dealing with the mercy seat in the place of the holiness of holiness. All right. So, but also, I want you to keep in mind, brothers and sisters. Now, Jesus, this is Jesus' first resurrection appearance. But Mary Magdalene, the one where the 7 demons was cast out of. Now, don't forget that. The one that the 7 demons were cast out is there at the tomb.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God. Somebody just missed it. See, they're there. Like Mary. Peter and John had went to the tomb, looked inside, and left. Got me? But Mary was what? Present mm-hmm. at Jesus' death. Came to the tomb, what? Early. Mm-hmm. Now, here, this is the same Mary. Now, she's now what? Overcomes her grief. Overcome with grief. She's overcome. Look, because she's dealing with this thing that somebody must have taken his body.
Yeah.
Isn't that something?
Mm-hmm.
And now, in that she's carrying on a conversation with an angel. Well, with two angels. With an angel, what?
Two angels.
Mm-hmm. And so I thought about it, and the angel. Now, I want y'all to listen to this, because this is an awesome statement. And go back where the garden and what he said. He said here, why are you crying? Verse 15, dear woman, why are you crying? Jesus asked her, who are you looking for? Now, look here. Jesus asked her. She looked around and Jesus was there.
Mm-hmm.
All right? But now, the angels was already there.
Mm-hmm.
But the angels are messengers of God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. You ever thought, look at the word evangelize? Evangelize means I'm taking a message. All right?
Mm-hmm.
But if you look, and this is going to be a note for somebody tonight. When you look at that word evangelize, you want to write it down. Take off the EV off the front. Take off the IZE at the end. You got the word angel. Now somebody look and say, ooh. Now look, think about that.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. There's angel in evangelize. And an angel is a messenger.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that awesome?
That's right.
Oh, that's enough to make you want to shout. So I need to give it to you again. The word evangelize. It's E-V-A-N-G-E-L-I-Z-E. If you take the E-V off the front and take off what? The I-Z-E.
Mm-hmm.
Then right in the middle you got what?
Angel.
Lord have mercy. That's no back to shout. But what really caught my attention was in the 15th verse says that what? I want to read from the King James Version. It said, and Jesus said unto her, woman, why weepest thou? Who seekest thou? She what? Supposing him to be the gardener. Look, that word, that was the key word to me, supposing. Mm-hmm. I want y'all to think about that tonight. Supposing. Isn't that something?
She thought.
Right. And that, supposing. Mm-hmm. That's a word. Many Christians are miserable tonight. Mm-hmm. Why? Because they suppose something that is not all true. Mm-hmm. I need to say that again. They suppose something that's not all true. Suppose. And it's right there. But praise His holy name. But this is what I love about it. And even in that tomb, you can see the description of the angels in verse 12. And once again, I say, remind us of that mercy seat where in the Holy of the Holy, that was Exodus, 25, 17, 19. Mm-hmm. But watch this. This is what got my attention. Only when He speaks her name does Mary recognize who He is. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. I need to say that again. Only when He speaks her name does Mary recognize Jesus. Isn't that something? Mm-hmm. Jesus called His own by name.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Let's look at the Bible. Let's go to John. I'll give you some scripture. I'm going to soon close it out. He called them by the name. John chapter 10. Write it down. Remember, she only recognized who it was when He called her by her name. Amen. That's what I love tonight. We ain't got to be jealous about anyone tonight. Mm-hmm. When the Lord saved, He saved who He wanted. If you want to get saved, He'll save you.
That's right.
Amen. You got to be mad with no one tonight. And then the thing about it, He called you by your name. Mm-hmm. Amen. When He called my name, He didn't get my name mixed up with Tony. He said, Sonny.
That's right.
Amen. What I said, John chapter 10, mm-hmm. Look at verse 3 and 4.
Okay.
Uh-huh.
It said, to him the porter opened and the sheep heard And the sheep heard his voice.
All right.
And he called his own sheep by name.
Go ahead.
And leadeth them out.
Oh, listen at that. Y'all heard it. I'm not making it up now. Mm-hmm. Read verse 4.
And when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them. And the sheep followeth him, for they knew his voice.
Listen, I'm reading from the Living Translation. Thank you, sister. Mm-hmm. That's John chapter 10. Look at verse 3. It said, the gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep recognize his voice and come to him. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. Mm-hmm. Lord, look at him. This is all this awesome tonight. Verse 4. After he had gathered his own flock, he walks ahead of them, and they follow him because they know his voice. They know his voice. Mm-hmm. Isn't that awesome tonight, brothers and sisters? They know his voice.
Isn't it just ironic that when the Lord called you to give your life to Him,
Lord Jesus?
And like I said, when God touches you,
my Lord,
you're not the same.
Amen. Amen.
But when He really touches you and touches your life, I don't know, He may not speak to everybody. And I'm not saying in Europe like I'm talking to you, but He speaks to you in an audible voice.
Yes.
And when He speaks, you listen.
My God.
Because I remember when He spoke to me, I stopped and looked.
Look, yeah, yeah.
So where is it coming from?
Where is it coming from?
But He told me what I needed to hear.
Yeah, yeah.
So when He speaks, we listen.
We listen. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Thank you. Let's go to Isaiah. Thank you, Sister Bridget, for that observation. Because like she said, she looked. It's almost like an audible voice. She heard the voice. Mm-hmm. Amen. And knew who voice it was.
That's right.
See, so we got to be careful because the devil talked to you.
This voice is not like a voice. It's a different voice.
It's a different voice. Amen. Isaiah 43 and 1. Look at Isaiah 43 and 1. Here's another scripture. Might want to write it down. Isaiah 43 and 1. Amen.
It says, but now thus said the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee,
listen,
O Israel.
Listen.
Fear not, for I have redeemed thee.
Uh-huh.
I have called thee by thy name.
Listen.
Thou art mine.
Listen, that's it right there. Oh, my God. You know what Isaiah said? Amen. Look at that 43rd, and I'm reading from the New Living Bible, translation, New Living. said, but now, O Jacob, listen to the Lord who created you. Now, O Sonny, now, O Janet, listen to the Lord who created you. Mm-hmm. Huh? O Israel, the one who formed you says, look what it said, do not be afraid, for I have ransomed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. Amen. And I believe that's what happened to Mary in that tomb tonight, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Mary, grief prevented her immediately from recognizing Jesus. But when Mary finally recognized him, she knew Jesus. Because Sister Bridget, like Sister Bridget just said, the way he spoke to her.
Right.
That makes a difference. The way he spoke to her, Mary could not wait to share the good news. Isn't that something? But to bear witness of the Lord. Scholars, brothers and sisters, note the significance of Jesus' first appearance. Right. Rather now, look here, the first significance of his appearance. Don't miss this. Rather than appearing to Pilate and Cephas, one of the disciples, Jesus appeared to Mary. Did not appear to the disciple, but appeared to Mary. Now here's a thought. It's a thought for you. No Jewish author would have chosen a woman to be the first to see the resurrected Christ. No. You know what they say? No what? Jewish author would what? No Jewish would have chosen a woman to be the first to see the resurrected Christ. Mm-hmm. Mary, here's a note. Mary was given, watch this, you might want to write it down, the responsibility of reporting what she had seen. Mm-hmm. Mary, I didn't say it again, was given the responsibility of reporting what she had seen. What? The risen Christ. Mm-hmm. This duty carried out what? Faithfully.
Amen.
And like Sister Bridget said, she remained. Amen. She stayed what? With the Lord. Isn't that awesome? Amen. And also, here's another note. You might want to write this down. We're almost closing it out. A good transformation is irresistible. I'm talking about a good transformation is irresistible. All right? And you know, television, that when I don't know the name of that show, baby, but we look at one about the houses. One you can love it and list it, and then the one out of Mississippi when they take that old house, it don't look like nothing, and they're out of Meridian somewhere in Laura, Mississippi, and they take old house don't look like nothing, and they go in and they what, remodel that house, amen, make it look brand new from the outside to the inside, amen. And I thought about this. I thought about the way Mary Magdalene was when Jesus met her in her condition. Mm-hmm. She was a house tore up from the floor.
Yeah.
Good God Almighty. And look what God did. God said, look, before I can fix this house, I got to get some stuff out of you.
Mm-hmm. Good it out.
Good it out. Oh, girl, Lord have mercy. Got to gut it out. And when you look at some of them TV shows, they gut it out. And they had to gut it out because they get ready to put something new in it.
That's right.
And that's what the Lord did. And so God, as we close, and oh, it's good. I'm telling y'all, I got to hear me close. God is the builder. He's the designer. Mm-hmm. He takes people in any condition. Somebody ought to shout on that note right there. I said, he takes people in any condition because all of us was messed up in one time. But he takes up. Mm-hmm. He takes us at any condition. And look what he do. And his power can make even the most undesirable characters. Isn't that something? Mm-hmm. And to the powerful vessels of his love and grace.
Right.
He can do it. God can do it. And that's what I love about him tonight. Mm-hmm. Not only that, as we get ready, my brothers and sisters, get ready to close this lesson out tonight. So if you have anything, I'm going
to
say this. Jesus spotlights. This is what I love about in this lesson, women of value. That's what I know. Mm-hmm. He spotlight women of value. Women of importance. Women are included, watch this, in the kingdom of God and in the ministry of Jesus. Women are what? Included.
Mm-hmm.
And what? The kingdom of God and in the ministry of Jesus. Mm-hmm. I like what the lesson says here. Closing out the liberating lesson part says that Mary Magdalene example to us as an individual was twofold. I love this. First, she reminded us to allow God to transform our life. And the Bible said, be not conformed to the world, Romans 12 and 2. But be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Second, she shows us what it means to be faithful followers and friends. In a world where so much seems temporary and fleeting, Mary teaches the relationship with Jesus. Lord, isn't that good? Mary's example to our churches is not to be what? Hasty and walk away from the empty tomb. Right. 2 minutes and walk away from the empty tomb. Amen. Huh? All right? So remember this, brother. May reminds the church to remain steadfast. What somebody said earlier. There is yet hope.
Yeah.
Praise his holy name.
Amen.
God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. Pray that we said something tonight that will encourage you to understand that sometimes you might be the only one following Jesus. Mm-hmm. But you keep on following him. Because I want you to know there's something at the end waiting for you.
Amen.
God bless you. Let's remember the sick and shut in. And also we want to remember Sister Dorothy Spain. We missing on Sunday the passing of her brother, mm-hmm. Brother Richard Vault. Amen. Passed this week. They're going to have a memorial service there in the home there in the Little River area. So let's keep that family lifted up in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
Also, Reverend Chestnut, Lonnie Chestnut, who was a former pastor there where I'm pastoring. Amen. Wife passed. It's a Chestnut. Want to keep that family lifted up in prayer. And all the others who we may not know, but you know and God knows them. Our friends in Georgia. I'm my brother. My sister-in-law, Betty, there's so many that are sick and shut in.
Mm-hmm.
And the Williams, Sister Gage's family, Williams family, Davis, Sister Karen Davis and family. There's so many. Paul, Paul Mosley and family. Just pray. It's praying time. So we thank God, because prayer still works.
Yes,
also, we want to thank you for tuning in. Once again, tonight, let us not forget to tune in on Facebook. On each week, we acknowledge, honor within the Black History Month. We want to honor either one that is already going on with the Lord, then maybe we want to honor one that is still here on this side. Amen. But I think it's a great thing, so we do thank Brother Braden Bridges for putting that out on the social media. So please tune in. Check them out. Amen. And continue to pray. And let me say it this way. We thank God for the trailblazers.
Amen.
Those who made the trail. Amen. But also I thank God for those who are coming behind the trailblazers. That's us. Amen.
Is the car radio ready?
The car radio is not ready. We were still working on it. We got some little, we were trying to get it where you can at least come to the parking lot and listen from your car from the radio. So we're still working on some things. Mm-hmm. On that, but we'll soon let you know. Amen. If you cannot, if you don't want to come in, at least you can pull up in the parking lot.
Amen.
But we'll let you know when that is complete. God bless you, and may heaven smile upon you. Let us have a word of prayer. Mm-hmm. Eternal God, our Father, we pray for you. Thank you for this word tonight. Thank you, Lord, for reminding us of the example of Mary Magdalene, one who was demons, had demons, but met Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
And when she met Jesus, the life turn around.
Changed.
Thank you for the change.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
Lord,
you.
Lord, we thank you for those who are like Mary Magdalene. We pray for them tonight. Lord, if they were listening, that regardless of their condition, once they meet you, you can turn them around as well. So now, Lord, thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Bless, Lord, the names that were called, the sick and shut in, the bereavement family. You know them name by name. Father, have your way. Manifest yourself.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name, we thank you tonight. Remember my family, the Bridges family. I pray for my sister-in-law and all those names we call, God.
Yes.
Then I remember my wife and my family, Lord.
Yes.
Not only my family, but all family. We
yes.
pray for this United States. Continue to manifest yourself, God. Continue, Lord, to let people know you are still God. Let them know you are still in control of this whole world. So God bless our going out, our coming in, till we meet again. For us in Jesus' name.
Jesus
in
name.
Jesus' name we do pray and thank you. And all of God's children say amen,
amen,
amen, amen, and amen. Remember, stay safe and stay saved. God bless you.